Hi everyone. I just wanted to give you an intro as to what the book looked like before I started in the papers. I used the Art of Life collection from KaiserCraft, and I had the 12 by 12 and the smaller 6.5 by 6.5, but for this book I primarily used the smaller book. The book I got at Joann's, it's just a cardstock book and with chipboard pages and envelopes in between. I used Gathered Twig Distress Ink on the whole thing, all the pages and all the edges of the book. I used Eileen's Tacky Glue and smoothed the glue out to attach the pages. And I'm only going to show you the front and the back. You don't need to see me glue it all down. Just gives you an idea. I did fuss an awful lot about where the edges went in here to those coils, and I didn't need to. When you got done and you had it inked and all glued down, you didn't even see that. Here I'm just inking around the edges and re-gluing a few things down. So next I'll show you how the finished book looked. Hold on for just a moment. Hi everyone, this is Patty. I'm here today with a design team project for Cut at Home. And you saw the previews as to what I was using and the start of the book. And now I want to show you how I finished it off. I took one of the stickers. This is the KaiserCraft Art of Life collection. I took one of the stickers from the collection and covered it with glossy accents. This I fussy cut from the paper and I put every day on the main piece and moments on the other. And these books, I believe I got this at Joann's. I think it's a Hampton Art, and I think I paid like $2.50 for it or less. And you untie the string. I did glue it with some Fabri-Tac to the inside of the book. I've covered each page with paper from the collection, and there is some kind of an element on each page as well that holds the tag. These are cut from the Super Ellipse dies, the Spellbinders Nest Abilities, and I use two different sizes. And I just inked them with the Gathered Twig Distress Ink on each one. I figured whoever gets this book could use these as templates for their pictures or put their picture, cut it out, put the picture on one side and journal on the other. On this side, I've taken a little piece from the collection. It says, "I'll always treasure this moment." And I've backed everything that I've cut out this way on heavy cardstock or other paper from the collection. And then left an opening so it just slides under. You flip it over. I have covered it again with the designer paper. Left this on an angle so that the mat slips right into it here. It says, breathe it all in love. Breathe it all in, love it all out. I can't read today, geez. There are three pockets. I didn't put anything in the pockets. I figured maybe whoever gets this would like to put memorabilia or more photos or whatever. This one says, be as awesome as you can. This is just a wonderful collection. I just really, really like this paper. I distressed everything heavily with the Gathered Twig all over each page. These are just scraps that I cut out as I was doing, I'll show you here, as I was doing around this edge. So this is a piece that cut out. So I used it on this side just as a focal point to tie the pages together. This one says here and now, double matted this way. And then we have never give up on a dream. Just because of the time it will take to accomplish it, the time will pass away. Beautiful, beautiful papers. This is just a cutout from the paper, and I backed it with another piece of the paper so it was a little bit heavier as this gets a photo on it or photos in here to stick it in. And I didn't attach it at the top or the bottom, just along the side. And something else I wanted to show you also, I don't know whether any of you have one of these. It's a gum eraser, and I use it especially when I'm using Beacon's Fabri-Tac or my ATG. It doesn't work as well on the tacky glue or the wet glues. But now, like, I notice here, and I don't know whether you can see it on camera, but it will bug me to death. I used Fabri-Tac on this. And there's a little line where it shoots out after it dries. And I take my gum eraser over all of these, and it just peels it up. I'll have to go back and finish this one up. But these are like under $3. They are really, really worth it to have in your craft tools. And then here's another one. This one says, enjoy the little things in life, and popped up. Now this page I goobered in. There, I used mostly the 6x6, or I guess it's 6.5x6.5 pad. And I didn't realize that I had cut this one that had the decorative area and the hole in it. And I cut it again. So then the only piece I had left was too short. But I did have this little strip from the paper. So I just added it onto the bottom. And that's a great way to extend your papers if you don't have enough. Or if you're trying to use up what you have. Just put a couple combinations of papers together and glue them together. Make a bigger sheet. Here's this one. This is another piece that I cut off that went this part here. And I cut it off and I put it here with a sticker from the collection. Again, I glued on just the three sides so that this will slip in. Isn't this just gorgeous? Just gorgeous paper. And I have a lot left. I have almost the whole 12x12 pack and a lot of the 6x6. So you will see other projects coming along that use this paper line. And here's another one. I put this one on the angle just because I liked the focal point of it. Backed it on the solid cardstock, and then slide the mat underneath. Another one here. And then on the back, here's a film strip. It was too long, so I cut it off, put a brad in the top, and then attached it with the Fabri-Tac. And then this one, I used my, I think it's a 2¼-inch punch to just punch out. And attach this to it and put the butterfly on it, and then it slides in. So this is a super simple book. Like I said, I think I picked them up at Joann's, but I'm sure other places have them too. You just slide the cording through, and then you tie it. And like I said, I did glue it down with Fabri-Tac so that it will stay tied. And I took, let me get this tied here. I took Glossy Accents and I put it on the end, and then I just twisted the fibers here so that it wouldn't keep fraying apart. But there's my little book. Hope you like it. Give it a try. Check out this paper line. It is absolutely gorgeous. Okay, I'll have some still photos for you following. Thanks a lot. If you're not a subscriber, I hope you become one today. Comments most welcome. Always appreciated, and I try to answer them all. Bye now. Happy crafting.